In this video, I want to help you come up with a study schedule for the last 2 weeks of bar prep. So the first thing that I want to put out there is that you know yourself best. You know yourself better than any person or commercial bar prep course does. So don't feel bad about straying from a schedule that someone else made. A lot of people feel uncomfortable to, you know, do something different than what their bar prep course is telling them to do. But remember what I'm telling you now. You know yourself better. You know your strengths. You know your weaknesses. In these last few weeks of bar prep, you really need to harness those. So feel free to stray from your schedule. I'm giving you permission to come up with something that works best for you. So hopefully you're past that and you're willing to continue to listen. So if you're making your own study schedule for the last few weeks of bar prep, I want to help you. So how do you prepare or schedule for the MBE subjects? Well, first things first, we recommend that you review an MBE topic or subject each day. But instead of sitting down and saying, it's Monday, I have to review real property and you have a 100-page outline, don't do that. Instead, decide that you're going to cover a subject and then spread it out over a few days. So real property is pretty dense. It will likely take you 2 to 3 days to meaningfully get through it. Torts, on the other hand, might only take you 2, and that's okay. So study an MBE subject each day, but be sure to space it out and give yourself a few days to cover a subject. Then, once you've decided which subjects you're covering when, make sure you are spending more time on those subjects that are harder for you. So I recommend that if real property is still a struggle, start with it and spend more time with it. Where if torts is a slam dunk, you know, still review it, but you don't have to spend as much time with it because that just doesn't make sense. You should be spending time on those things that are harder for you while not ignoring anything. Additionally, while you're also putting together your study schedule for the MBE subjects, make sure you're factoring in time to do practice questions each day. There's no magic number about how many questions you should do. A lot of it is dependent upon how much you've already done and how you're performing. So I unfortunately can't tell you exactly how many to do, but you should plan on practicing some each day. Now, when it comes to preparing for the written portion and or the essay portion of your exam, you should also make sure that you're making a final review of each testable subject. So, you know, write down or find a list of all of the testable essay only subjects and make sure that you're spreading them out over the course of your schedule. This might mean you're looking at a few essay topics each day. That's okay. Just make sure you're putting them together correctly. Like conflicts of law might not take you as long to get through as secured transactions, for instance. So you want to make sure you're pairing them up realistically. Additionally, this is where it's helpful to make sure you're spending more time with those subjects that are likely to be tested. There are certain subjects that are bar exam favorites and they show up on every single bar exam. And then there are certain subjects that are rarely tested. Now, I'm not giving you a green light to ignore anything, but what I am stressing is that you should use your time wisely. And I would first focus on those subjects that are more likely than not to come up, and then ultimately at some point reaching those other topics that are less likely to come up as well. Now, when you review your essay topics each day, plan some time to answer essay questions and review previous essay questions. And again, this is important because it's application practice. And it's also important because it's likely that if they were to test a topic that they have in the past, they're going to test it in a similar fashion. So reminding yourself of your past practice is really valuable. Now, if you're in a state that administers the MPT or the PT, make sure you're factoring in some time to practice those as well. Finally, there are some other things to factor into your study schedule, preferably, you know, not the week leading up to the bar exam, but you should practice taking a timed exam. Ideally, if you could simulate the bar exam 2 days back to back, that would be great. Again, you don't want to do this very close in time to the bar exam because it's exhausting and it loses its value. So maybe you could do it 2 weeks before the bar exam. Lastly, you need to get yourself physically prepared for the bar. So if you have a bad habit of staying up until 3 or 4 in the morning to complete your studying, but you sleep in till noon, the bar exam isn't going to comply with that schedule. So you want to make sure you start getting yourself on your bar exam schedule so that you're physically able to get it done. We hope this video helped you put together your own study schedule for the last 2 weeks of bar prep, and we have a sample schedule available for you on our blog as well.